Hello everyone, my name is Ayel Sari. Today I will show you the way how to delineate watershed by using digital elevation model in ArcMap. We will start from the definition of watershed. Watershed is a geographical area which have a common outlet and it is on boundary. And it can be also defined as which is a geographical area in which the water resource inside this area is flowing into a single common outlet. With this, watershed delineation is very important to make watershed management intervention works, by which if we delineate the watershed, we can know the geographical feature of the area and other essential watershed management planning parameters. After having the XY coordinate point of the outlet, we can delineate the watershed by using digital deviation model and ArcMap. So let's start to do this. So first we need to have ArcMap in our desktop or in our computer, and after this we can open. So here I have the ArcMap window. So after this, here we need to have the table of content. After this, the first thing to delineate the watershed is importing or adding the DEM. So let's start to add the DEM map. Here I have DEM or detail elevation model, 2 meter by 2 meter grid. So click add. This is a digital elevation model of the basin in which my watershed is flowing over. So after getting or after having this, we need to use Arc Toolbox. Opening the spatial analysis tool. Here, when I open the spatial analysis tool, here I have a lot of alternative or option. From those options, we need to use hydrology, and under hydrology, there are tools which are basin fill, flow accumulation, flow direction, flow length sink, snap point, stream link, stream orders, stream to feature, and watershed. So first we need to fill the DEM. So double click on fill, and here the input surface raster is the digital elevation model. So here we can change or rename the file name, and you can also change the folder in which our field map will be saved. So for the sake of this video, we can accept the default and click OK. And then it may take a while. Here the filling is wind up. So the next thing is flow direction. Click on flow direction, and here the input surface raster is fill, and here we can change the folder in which the flow direction map will be saved. For this video, we can accept as default and click OK. Here the flow direction is on process. The flow direction process is wind up, and the third step is double click on flow accumulation, and the input flow direction raster is the flow direction map. And here you can change the file name or the folder that wants to see. Okay, then here the flow accumulation process is going on. It may take a while, so we need to wait up to the end of the process. Here the process is wind up. So here the flow accumulation map is seems like this. So to identify the stream, we need to change the color of flow accumulation into visible colors. So double click on this and go to symbology, and here we need to classify it into two. Here the black color changed into white, and the white color should be changed into blue to look the stream or the flowings. Here we can see somehow invisible form. This is a stream order, or the stream order of the watershed. So after having this, we need to import or add the coordinate point or the geographical location of the outlet. So to add the coordinate point, we directly go to file and here add data, add XY data. Here we need to browse. Here we find the coordinate point data. Here I have the pull point data. So open or add, and here select the appropriate sheet number and add. Then here we need to specify the field. Here I have saved X and Y as XY, and the field, the Z field or the Z field, will be changed into Z. And here we need to project the coordinate system if the coordinate system is unknown, but in our case the coordinate point is projected, so we can directly say okay and here okay. Here is the pull point. So here we need to change into shape file to make an addition. So here we can change the point data into shape file by right click on this and directly go to data, then here export data. So here we can change the folder in which the shape file will be saved, but we can accept as default for the sake of this video. So here we can click OK. Yes, if we want to add the export data in the map layer, we can accept as yes. So here we can remove the sheet file. Here I have the exported or the shape file. So now we can edit, or you can move the pull point in nearby stream. So to do this, first we need to activate the editor. Here start editing. Here I export output or pull point. So okay, after this we can move into the area that we want. So here we can move into, for example, here. So after doing this, we can stop editing and save edit. After having this, going to the arc toolbox and snap pull point. So double click on the snap pull point. Here the input raster or feature pull point data. Here is a pull point, and we can pull point field. We can take field or take as default here flow accumulation and accept. The snap pull point can be processed simply, and the final step to delineate a watershed is click on a watershed, and here the input flow direction raster is flow direction map, and the input raster or feature pull point data is the snap pull shape file, and we can directly go to OK. Then the watershed delineation process is going on. So here the watershed delineation process is wind up. Here is our watershed, zoom to layer. This is our watershed, which can be generated by using the outlet. So finally, we need to convert from raster to polygon. This is why it may be required to calculate the area parameter and other required statistical parameters. So we need to convert from raster to polygon. So we need to go conversion tools. Here we have conversion tools. From the conversion tools, we need to select the from raster to polygon. Double click on this. Then here the input raster is watershed flow or the watershed. So here we can change the folder in which our watershed polygon will be saved, and we can change also the watershed, the delineated watershed name into if we say 80, simply 80, and okay. Here the raster is changing to polygon, so we can delete all the steps that we follow. So this is our delineated watershed. So by using this, by opening the attribute table, here the attribute table have object ID, shape ID, grid code, shape length, shape area. So we can here add field. The field name is, for example, if we want to calculate the area, here we can say area in hectare. And here you can change the data type into, for example, long integer, float, double, text, data, date, blob, raster, and guide. For area, it is better to use short integer, and you can say OK. And if we want parameters, here we can add another field and say perimeter, and here we can calculate by using calculate geometry, and here we can change the unit of measurement into from meter into meter square into area hectare. Okay, and here we can accept us. Here we can calculate geometry and convert the property into perimeter. Here into meter or kilometer, for example, into kilometer, and okay, yes. So here you can calculate the area and perimeter. The area of our watershed that we can delineate is 500 hectare, and the perimeter is 10 kilometer. So this is all about the way of delineating watershed from digital elevation model by using ArcMap. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel. And if you have any question and suggestion, please write on the comment part. Thank you for watching.